Well, Sarah Burke was considered a pioneer in freestyle skiing, and perhaps more than any other person was responsible for making it an Olympic sport. Her life cut tragically short this week when she died after being first seriously injured in practice. CNN medical correspondent Elizabeth Cohen now explaining the dangers of the sport.
John, witnesses say that Sarah Burke whiplashed onto that hard, icy surface. That was the term they used, whiplashed. And actually, the injury was not to her head. The injury was to her neck. She actually tore a vertebral artery. That's one of the arteries that carries blood to the brain. And when she tore it, she went into cardiac arrest, and also her brain was deprived of oxygen. And John, the next day, surgeons did go in and try to stitch up that injury. They tried to fix it, but she had just been deprived of oxygen for too long, and they did end up taking her off of life support. Now, this wasn't Burke's first injury. In fact, 2 years ago, she did break a bone in her back, but was able to get back to work relatively quickly. In 2009, another snowboarder by the name of Kevin Pierce, he had a traumatic brain injury, and he was actually out of the sport for quite a while. He's only just now getting back to it. He was in the hospital for 5 months. He said he just couldn't get back to the sport, and then he was sort of hesitant to get back to the sport, but he now is actually back into it. You know, this, when we talk to folks about this sport, they said it's not an incredibly dangerous sport. It doesn't have the injury rates that other sports might have, but still, injuries do happen. She was using all the safety equipment that she was supposed to be using, we're told, but she didn't land on her head, so her helmet didn't help her. It may have been just sort of this strange kind of fluky way that she landed, but certainly a community now is in mourning for this very beloved skier. John?